What is going on, guys? We are back playing some more Surviving with Botania. Today, guys, we are going to be revisiting the Gourmaryllis. Now, if you don't know what this flower is, it's a very simple flower. You just feed it food and it will generate mana. So there's a lot of different ways that you can set up farms to actually get this to work and get a ton of mana. And we've already gone through one of the farms that you can set up, although it's slightly cumbersome. It's a very large farm. It's a little bit tedious to set up, but it is the big potato farm that is over there. We set it up a couple episodes ago. If you haven't already seen that, I think it's a pretty cool video if you want to go watch it. Although what we're going to be setting up today is going to be a lot more efficient, more compact, and overall just kind of an easier thing to deal with. So we're going to be setting up a cow breeder and cow killer that's going to utilize a lot of different things from Botania to breed, kill, and then cook the meat and give it to the Gourmaryllis. So in this chest right here, there's everything we are going to need and then some. And the reason I say that is because everything in here except for the floating bergamute and the floating rosa arcana is going to be required for this setup, but these two flowers are not actually needed. They just make it a lot better. So the Rosa Arcana, if you don't know what this does, basically will take experience and it will turn it into mana. Now, it's not a ton of mana, but when you breed cows, you're going to get experience and it's really just going to start sitting on the ground there because it's going to be in an enclosed area that you probably won't be going over to a ton. So if you're breeding a lot of these cows, it's going to kind of build up and it's just better to get rid of it, especially if you can turn it into some mana. So that's what the Rosa Arcana is going to do. It does not have a big range, so it's going to go basically in the center of our farm, but you don't need it if you really don't want it. The next one is the floating bergamute. Now this is going to be really crucial for me because it allows me to reduce the noise that cows are going to make. And of course, if we're recording episodes and we're around this farm, the cows are going to be really loud because we're going to have a ton of them in there. So this will generate negligible amounts of mana. It really is only there to get rid of the sound. I don't even believe it's on the generating flora page of this. So if we go back, we can see that it is under functional flora. And it's one of the first ones that comes up. And it says, it absorbs sound emitted in a close radius around itself, converting it into negligible amounts of mana and emitting it. So it requires no mana to function, but it doesn't give you any mana either. So it's kind of just, you know, a flower that's there to assist with getting rid of noise. So it's really nice, but you really don't need it unless you're going to record a video using this. Along with that, one thing that can be interchanged is going to be this Corporea funnel and Corporea spark. So it might be best to hook this up to a Corporea network, mainly just because you're going to need a wheat farm eventually, since this is going to be using a ton of wheat to breed the cows. And so hooking it up to a Corporea network makes it a little bit easier to kind of wirelessly transport the wheat to where you need it to be. Of course, though, you can use, you know, a regular pressure plate hopper open crate setup that'll just drop one wheat at a time and you can manually refill it. It's just a little bit more tedious to do because of how much wheat we're going to be going through. Now, of course, I don't have an automated wheat setup, so I have about 2 stacks of wheat right here that we can use and just manually input it, kind of as a proof of concept, and then either off camera or in a couple episodes, I will make an automated wheat farm that will end up filling this up using the Corporea network. So there are 2 flowers that we need to make, and I always like to make the main flowers that we're going to be using on camera. So we're going to be using the dreadthorn, which basically is a flower that is going to kill only adult animals. So it's pretty interesting in that it only does kill adult animals, because of course we don't want to be killing the baby animals. We want the drops from the adult animals, and that's basically what makes this whole farm work. So we just got to fill this up over here. Now this one is a really cheap flower, and I was kind of surprised. If you look at it, it doesn't even require any rune. It's just 3 black petals, 2 cyan petals, and a redstone root. So we can hop up here, toss all of this stuff in here, and we will be good to go. So there we go. Now the next one we are going to be making, and I really, really hope I can pronounce this right, is going to be a, let me just hover over it so I can see the name, pollidisiac is what I'm going to say. Now the reason I say it like that is because it's going to breed your cows for you, assuming there is the wheat dropped on the ground near it. So I kind of assume it's pronounced like aphrodisiac. Now if you click on this, it requires a new rune that we have yet to use, the rune of lust, and that is what's kind of goes along with the theme of breeding the cows, and it really isn't that difficult to make. It requires 2 mana diamonds, rune of air, and rune of summer. So I believe that is a 3rd tier rune. So it's kind of tedious because you need to make a bunch before that, but we've got all the stuff right here to make it. So we'll do that, and I should have a water bucket on me right now. Yep, there we go. So throw this in there. So the Rune of Fire, Lust, 2 red petals, an orange petal, and 2 pink petals, and get the seeds out, and there we go. So these are the 2 main flowers we need. I'm going to make both of them floating because I think they look better like that. So there we go, and there we go. Now something I want to add, I will link in the description where this whole concept came from. It's not a direct copy, but I got a great idea from this video. And unfortunately, the video is a little bit outdated, and I saw a bunch of people in the comments posting that they have been having issues with the setup. Now the setup is flawless, except for the fact that the Dreadthorn was changed. So unfortunately, the Dreadthorn now has an area around it that is not shown by the mana seer, or the monocle that allows you to see the area. And it basically only shows a 2-dimensional area that it will go length and width wise, but it goes to a height of 6. And so we need to move this Dreadthorn down from the original setup. So that's basically really the only issue. The original video will be linked in the description though. So just something to add, if you've had this setup before and are having issues, the Dreadthorn now has a larger area to it. And unfortunately, we cannot make a petite version. So we're going to grab all of this stuff out. It is a relatively large setup that we have to do. Then we've got the Gourmaryllis, of course, Hopperhawk, the Bergamute, the Rosa Arcana, and an Exoflame for cooking our stuff. Now we're not really going to need this bucket today. I'm going to grab this water bucket out. And we'll put these 2 mana tablets back in here. We don't need those. And we should be good to go. Now I'm going to be using some glass and some living rock brick, but really you just want some building blocks. I would suggest you use glass mainly just because you want to see what's going on, but you don't have to. You'll probably need about 2 stacks though. So come over here. Now up on top, I do have a bunch of cows. I got pretty lucky. There were a bunch of cows that spawned around me. You can see on the map, there are still a fair bit of them. So it wasn't that bad to lure them over. I just brought them from up there, walked them down. I didn't even get rid of my staircase yet, and then walked them up. And the reason I have them here in this long dirt thing here is because we're going to be placing them somewhere around this block. I don't want them to get hurt when they fall down, but we're going to be putting them around here. And it's kind of a pain in the butt because it's going to be sort of floating. So I thought it'd be easy to just get them up there before the episode and then drop them down somewhere in here eventually. So first things first, we are going to need to pick a 3x3 area. Now this is where we're going to be storing all of this stuff. And so I've decided that this will be the center block of the 3x3 area. And once we have that, we will say, I guess what we can do is take a brick slab. You're going to find the center block and you can go up 3 blocks. So we'll go up 1, 2, 3. And then it really is up to you if you want to go up higher than that. But I'm going to go up 3 and then I guess we can put this down and see, because really it depends on if you want to use the Bergamute and if you want to use the Rosa Arcana, because these are going to be going directly in the center here. So we will take this living rock brick and put this down here in the center block, and we will put the Rosa Arcana right there. So it's going to go right on top of the center block. Now if we could see this, we would see that it really only has a 3x3 area to pick up stuff in. And it is eating my it's eating my experience right now. When it takes experience from a player, it's a lot more effective than taking it from experience like points on the ground, but it's perfectly fine. It makes it a lot easier. You don't have to come in here and pick stuff up. The next thing we're gonna do is put down our Bergamute right above that. So we can put that down right here. Now this is just going to get rid of the noise. And then next what we can do is come up here and put down our half slab right above that. So really if you wanted to, you can put this down one higher. It doesn't really matter, but I'm putting it down just so it's as compact as possible. Then we can break this block right here. Well, actually, I guess we don't want to break this just yet. We're going to take half slabs and put it all around this block. I got to break this torch right here. Put it around this block right here, and then we can break this central block, and we are going to be putting some water down. Now, this is going to make it a lot easier to drop the cows down here, so we'll do that. And what this whole setup right here allows us to do is have the fully grown cows, the adult ones, in this water right here. And then the baby cows will just kind of shoot out down here around the sides. And of course, we will encase this very, very soon. But that's basically the whole idea, is it's going to allow the baby cows to be filtered out and brought down into this 3x3 area. Now we can put the glass down in this 3x3 area and just kind of make it look nice and fancy. So we don't really need glass on these sides right here. We're not going to be able to see in. But right here in the front, we can put glass down, and we'll do kind of a window like this. And then we can put down the living rock around the sides and kind of bring it all the way up, because we don't want the baby cows being spit out and just get stuck in a random block in here. So we're going to want to make sure we fill all of it up so they really can only fall straight down. And I'll put a torch in there eventually. It's going to get a little bit dark, but we'll break these torches since they're really not crucial. Fill in this area up here. And there we go. So put some torches in there just so we light it up a little bit. It's a little bit easier to see. And there we go. So this whole area should be basically done for the most part. We can fill in glass all the way up, so it's a little bit easier to see here. But I need to put down the dreadthorn first. Now, this is kind of the last step that needs to go in the base here. And the reason I waited until now to do it is because of the changes made to the dreadthorn. Now, the biggest problem is that if you have the dreadthorn too close to your adult cows up here, it'll kill them. And we really don't want that because, of course, those are our breeding animals, and you've worked so hard to get them into this nice one-by-one area in the water, and so you don't want to kill them, you want them to live. So, we only really want it killing animals in these blocks right down here. So we're going to come here, and we can move it down a little bit more than what I'm going to do here, but we're going to count down 7 blocks, so 1, 2. Now I got to make sure this pick is not active, okay, so it's not, but we're going to go down from this block, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and get to the bottom and do 7. So we're going to be putting it down here, and that should be perfectly fine. I think we can move it down. Honestly, we can move it down one more, and I'm going to move it. You know what? Actually, we'll leave it right here. It should be fine at this block, so then it'll be a range of 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So it should not kill the cows up there. They should be one above it. So we'll throw this down right here. Now something you got to keep in mind is it's bound to a mana pool right now, but it's not bound to the correct mana pool. So I am going to, I guess unfortunately, break my way out of here. And we're going to put down a fresh mana pool somewhere over here. It's probably bound to one of these mana pools right here. But we can put down a fresh mana pool pretty much right, I guess we can do it right. It really depends on where we want this whole setup to be. But for now, we can put it down basically right here. So we'll put the mana pool down right there. We will, oh, nope, we don't want that. We want to get this down here, and we want to bind it to that mana pool right there. So it's going to be taking that mana, and of course it's not going to kill anything right now because there really shouldn't be any mana in here right now, unless that's transferring some over. But now that whole setup is good to go, so we can fill in this area right here, and we really never have to deal with that again, unless, of course, we drop these cows down from up here, and they start getting killed, which would not be ideal. But luckily we have cows around here, so we can kind of fix that if it does happen. So now that we have these bricks, slabs down here, we can fill in with glass right up here. We can fill in with basically anything. I'm just going to do glass though, so we can see the cows once they are in there. And you could hear that was a little bit quiet. That's because the bergamute did absorb some of the sound. And now we should honestly be good to drop our cows down into here. So I guess I'll build up with some living rock right here just so I can start breaking this dirt. And I am going to build up one more with living rock right here and just kind of go up like so. Oh, okay, so the cows will be basically right there. So we can break this and they will now all drop down. So really the big test right now will be I'm going to break these and then we're going to go and we're going to put some mana in the mana pool. And we are going to make sure that our cows do not get killed. So we'll put that there. We can break all of this. Now the hard part has been completed. Getting the cows in there is really the most difficult and annoying task. And I just want to get these blocks in here. And why did I fill that back in with glass? I have no clue. But we're going to throw down. I guess we can come over here. And since it's not hooked up to a network yet, we can grab our mana tablet. And we can toss it down in here. And assuming these cows don't get killed. Okay, so that's really the test. The dreadthorn will not kill them. That's pretty much what I suspected, but it's always good to check. Now this one right here, we can just make sure they're all bound to the correct mana pool. Now this one needs a mana spreader, and so will the Gourmaryllis. So we've got the mana spreader right here. We can really put it down anywhere. I'll probably end up putting it down right over in this corner just because it's kind of out of the way. So let's bind that there. That is bound to that one. Okay, so it is now transferring my experience into mana right here. I assume it's going to start consuming it when we get closer. Yeah, so you can see the area that it has is really just this block right here. That's really interesting. Okay, so it actually generates a fair bit of mana from that. But Now we should be good in here, so we can kind of start filling in this area since we don't need to do any more work inside of there. So we can take some living rock now if we don't really want to see all of this and fill that in, fill in the side here. And I'm going to make a staircase up just because we do need to get up here then. And fill in this one last block right here just to make sure when the baby cows shoot out, they do not go all over the place randomly. And I guess actually what we probably want to do is fill in a block right here and then fill in up here, because we are going to want a little bit of a workspace right here to do some of the work with the other flowers that we need to use for this setup. So right here is where we can set up, and I guess we'll break this too, just to get some area. This is where we are going to be setting up all of the pollidisiac and the, the corporea funnel, all of this good stuff. So we can put down the pollidisiac right here, right next to him. Now this one will be functioning. It should be bound to this mana pool right here. We want to make sure they're all bound to this mana pool. And hop back up. We'll elongate the stairs because I do not have the flying capabilities yet. But then we are going to take a weighted pressure plate because we are going to be dropping items on this. And we can put it down. I don't know if this has a redstone root. I don't think it does. Okay, so it doesn't. So it's not affected by redstone. We can put this down directly next to it. And then we can take an open crate. I don't know if we need an open crate above this. I believe if we just wanted to put the funnel down, we could put it down above this, two blocks above it, and it would drop stuff. But we'll do this. And then we need to grab out our item frame so that we can indicate what this needs to drop. And we'll put it on. Oh, that's not what we wanted to do. Grab that. Oh, okay. So that must have gotten picked up by... What just picked that up? Something just picked that item frame up, and I don't know what it was. Huh. Okay, I'm a little confused on that one. What? Was there a hopperhawk over here that picked that up? Whoa. How did this farm get so messed up? Okay, something bad happened over here. Okay, there we go. Something bad happened over here, I guess, but I don't really know. Okay, we'll worry about that later. That got backed up earlier, and it was because a sapling fell into it, but you know what? I'm just going to fix this right now. We'll throw that there. This gets thrown in here. What is all this doing right here? That does not go in there. These do not go in there. Oh, it's because the item frame came off of these. How do the item frames come off of these? What? Okay, one second, guys. We're switching the episodes up a little bit. We need to fix this right there. Okay, put that back on there. There we go. Things are all fixed there. And where's the wood? The wood over here. Problem solved. How did that even happen? I have no idea. But get that out of there. Get that out of there. Okay, all should be good in the world now. There we go. Okay, back to this setup over here. I forgot what I was doing. We got the item frames back. Okay, so we have the item frame on there. Now we need to take and put wheat on here to indicate what the Corporea network is supposed to get out for us. Now this isn't going to be hooked up to a Corporea network right now, solely because it's not close enough. So we'll kind of have to make some intermediates throughout here. But if I really wanted to, I could just put down a chest over here, and that's probably what I'll do to kind of show how the whole process is going to work eventually. But we need to make the redstone setup because every time the Corporea funnel gets a redstone signal, it is going to drop one out. So we're going to make the redstone signal by using the pressure plate, put redstone here, brick here, put bricks down up here with redstone on those, and a redstone torch right there. So basically what that'll do, and we're going to have to reset this eventually because it gets a little buggy if you run out of wheat. Now that is kind of a problem, but if we run out of wheat, in this setup, basically the way you reset it is you're just going to break the redstone and place it back down, and that's going to create a pulse, and it'll make the Corporea funnel drop a new one. And then once that is dropped, the fact that it will trigger the redstone signal and actually create a loop again will fix the whole setup. So if you do run into a little bit of, you know, trouble with that, that is a way to fix it. So now what we can do to test this out, since this should have mana, is we can drop a little bit of wheat in here and it should start using it. I know obviously it's not as fancy as most of you would probably like, but we can just throw that all down right now. It's a little bit crude of a setup, but this should use up some of that. You can see that they should have started breeding. There really are only like five cows in there, so it won't use a ton up, but we should be able to come down here and see some baby cows. So there we go, the baby cows got shot out. We've got two of them because we only have five mature cows up there. Eventually, I can lure more in. It's really not that difficult, but really just a proof of concept, of course, for you guys to see that this works. So now these guys are not getting killed down here. There's no experience. They're not being super loud. Everything's looking perfectly fine. The Corporia network is hooked up. So now what we need to worry about is picking up all the drops and getting them cooked. So we have a hopper hawk ready to go right here, and we can put it on the front. So since everything up here is done, we can kind of fill this in, make it look a little bit nicer, like so. And I guess, I don't know if we actually really want to cover that one up right there. I'm going to break this so it looks a little bit nicer, but we can just do it like that. So there we go. Actually, no, we're gonna break this block right here. That'll look a little bit nicer so we can see in there at the cows, but we really don't need to go up there anymore. So really all that's left, again, is to separate the drops that we will get from the grown cows and then start cooking them up. So we can put down the hopper hawk if we really wanted right here, and that should pick up everything in there. And then we are going to put down one chest so that we can put down item frame and filter out the leather into this one. And we're going to get a lot of leather from this, more than we could possibly need. And then we're going to put down a hopper that will lead into a furnace. So the hopper will go right up here, furnace right there. Let's get that. Oh, that's not correct. That would work, but that's not correct. So put that down there and put the item frame on this. And then we are going to put the raw beef here and take out the charcoal that was not supposed to come in here, but is supposed to go over here into this setup. Drop that there. Should be getting a fair bit of mana from it. But now what we can do is take this and put down our exoflame. We can put it down right here, honestly. We can make sure that this is bound to this mana pool. This one is bound to this mana pool again. So it's all coming to this one centralized mana pool. And then we can put down, if we break down here and go down another one, and I'm going to say go down one more, we can put down our Gourmaryllis. Now, the reason I'm going down this far, and we really don't need to go down this far, I guess you could probably get away with going one more up, is just because we do not want this meat that is dropped in here to be consumed. You know what? We're actually going to put it down right here. That should be perfectly fine. But we just want to make sure that the meat that is dropped inside the 3x3 area is not consumed by the Gourmaryllis, but it should only have a 3x3 area for this, so it should not overlap with that at all. But we want to make sure it's cooked first, because if you don't know, the more effective food is, the more hunger it gives you, or I guess the more hunger it gets rid of, the more mana it generates. So cooking this is going to give us significantly more mana than it would if it was raw. So we're going to take this furnace right here. We are going to put down the, we need to go down one more. I forgot, because the open crate is going to be dropping at one. So it can get a little bit buggy with the open crate if it has a flower below it, just because it can sometimes see that as not being an open block, and therefore it will not drop it. So put down the Gourmaryllis, come back up here, put down the open crate. We don't even need to see down there. Actually, that's a lie. We do need to see down there real quick, because we need to make sure this is bound to that mana spreader. So, okay, whatever. We have this one selected. Now we can come back up here and bind it to that, right? It's bound to that. No. Bind it. Which one is it bound to right now? I think it's bound to that one, but I can't tell. Okay, you know what? This is how we're going to tell. We're going to throw some of this down there. Which one is this bound to? Okay, it is bound to that one. Okay, it's just kind of hard to see. Okay, so just had to make sure that that was the case. It is bound to that one, giving us a ton of mana getting put into here. You can see it's a very steady flow. You might even need to add some lenses to this eventually. If you add, you know, a couple more exoflames, you got a couple more cows in there, just to make sure it can transfer the mana fast enough. So we now have that. All we need to do is put down the hopper here. So it's going to pull out the cooked beef. It'll drop it into the open crate, drop it to the Gourmaryllis, and with one exoflame, you can consistently have this setup running, and you do not need to worry about it ever, you know, running out, or going too fast, I should say, and kind of overloading the Gourmaryllis. So really all that it comes down to now is waiting for the cows to grow, become adults, get killed by the dreadthorn. Obviously the dreadthorn will kill them. They are right now, they should be five above it, so it will get them in their range, they will die, and all the stuff will get put in here. One heads up, if you think you're going to be smart and try and kind of circumvent using this hopper up here, putting an item frame on a furnace is actually not going to work. I don't really know why. It should be considered an inventory, but it does not seem to work. So you are going to need the hopper on the top, even though you're only going to be cooking down the raw beef, and you're really not going to be getting a ton of it at a time. Unfortunately, you can't put the furnace directly adjacent to the hopper hawk, as far as I'm aware. If I'm wrong, feel free to correct me, but I thought I'd be smart earlier and do that, and it did not seem to work. But that is going to be it for today, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed the video and learned something. If you found it entertaining or informative in any way, please feel free to give it a like, as it does help me out a lot. And now comes the point where we're later in the episode and I can kind of talk casually about some stuff on the channel. Because as you may have noticed, the videos have been slowing down a little bit. That is because I am heading back to school. Actually, tomorrow, I'm heading back later in the day. I start back up on the 17th of January, so I will be busy a little bit again. So the videos will slow down a little bit, but I'm going to try and keep at least like a consistent 3 videos a week, maybe more, for the Hermit Pack, because that's pretty easy to record and upload. But just thought I'd let you guys know that the videos for the next week will probably slow down a fair bit, because I'm going to be moving everything back in and readjusting a little bit. Just a little bit of a heads up. But again, guys, thanks for watching. Hope you have a great day, and I will talk to you guys later.